Does your digital camera get too hot and turn itself off? I'm going to show you how I added a heatsink to my Panasonic to prevent that from happening. My name's Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber. In certain situations, I would get the following error message on my camera, and that's not good. Sometimes I would be in a room where it was just a little bit too warm for the camera, and I needed a way to prevent that from happening. So I added a removable heatsink to the back of my camera, and it works great. I'm going to use a piece of music, or sometimes called piano wire, to attach this heatsink to my camera, and you can follow the red dotted line, and I'm showing you how I'm going to be bending up this music wire and attaching it to the camera so that it's removable, basically hooking onto the camera and then through the fins of the heatsink. This gives you a little detail about how the wire sneaks out of the heatsink and then around the camera to grab it. The heatsink that I'm going to use is probably out of an old Dell, something I recycled. The good thing is I can flip up the screen and it's got a big flat surface that will give a lot of thermal transfer of the heat into the heatsink and works really excellent. I'm just marking out the spots here where I have to machine away for the cold shoe on the heatsink. I'm using a Sharpie here so I know where I'm going to machine. I cut away one of the edges on the heatsink, and I'm going to take this over to the sander. I'm going to grind it nice and flat because we don't need that. We're going to use the last fin to use that to grab onto the camera with. I have a cross slide vise mounted onto my drill press, and I'm just using some end mills here to machine out the area where the cold shoe and the camera gets mounted onto the tripod, so I have some room there so it can be flush onto the camera. And you can see here how that works out. Pretty clean, nice and simple. At this point, I realize I need to mill a couple of little slots for the wire to come off the heatsink so that they don't protrude from the heatsink so the camera can still lay flat, and I'm just machining them in on both sides of the heatsink here with a little probably 8th or 16th inch end mill bit. So the piano wire I'm using here is 0.055, that's about 1.3 millimeters. It's pretty stiff and plenty sturdy for what I need it to do. I basically bend it through the heatsink first, so I have two ends that I can wrap around the camera and work out. I find this works a lot better for stuff like this than starting from one end and working to the other. Sometimes things get a little bit tight with the wire, and that's not always the best way to go. So starting in the middle here is the best way I find to do stuff like this. I use a pair of needle nose pliers and a Sharpie to mark the wire wherever it needs to be bent, and it's just a matter of trial and error, taking your time, making little bends, making little adjustments until you get the two clips hooked onto the piece just right. This was a really fun build, probably took me all of about 4 or 5 hours. It's totally worth it in my opinion, as mirrorless cameras are the future of digital photography. Right here I'm trimming off the ends. This is the final product. Removable, works fantastic, and I still have access to the little flip-up screen. I like the Micro Four Thirds format because it's really small and compact, works really great for me in my studio and my design environment. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can click on the little icon on the bottom right of the screen to do that. You can follow me on Twitter, Facebook, and Google+. Rock on. Click here to watch some of my other design videos. And if you'd like to have your music featured in one of my videos, send me a message. I'm always looking for great new music to feature in my videos.